on one of the chairs. Maybe the coffee.
Yeah.
Thank you. All right, welcome back again to the Merlis Belcher Arena in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. This is the main rink for the 2024 Canadian Junior National Ball Hockey Championships. We move on to our second game of the day, Etobicoke Whalers and New Tecumseh Extreme, boys under 17. First look at both these teams here on pad number one. Games being played at four different arenas for these championships. We are at the main rink. This is the home of the University of Saskatchewan Huskies. And this is our second of eight games we'll bring you today. So we will get the national anthem. I believe we may be foregoing the national anthem for this one because teams are lining up at center. Normally they line up at the blue lines. So we will get underway in just a moment. New Tecumseh Extreme in the black red trim. The Etobicoke Whalers in the white green trim. The whale logo on the front. It's backhanded out by Neary. Lawton will throw it around behind his own goal. It goes to the far boards on it first. Is Del Colombo to Sulich, back behind the goal. And the Whalers will move it out up the right side. This is Clotten. Clotten trying to cut in towards the front of the goal. He does. The save is made. We'll get you the starting goaltenders in just a moment. Number 34, Ryan Vigneault in goal for New Tecumseh. And down the other end, just Michael Murphy in goal for Etobicoke. Faceoff won by New Tech. Can't get it out though. Shot coming in from Zach McAuliffe of Etobicoke. Stopped by Vigneault. Etobicoke player spinning off the boards. Caught an inadvertent high stick, and that is likely going to be 4 minutes for high sticking. That's going to be the indication from the official. Comes just a minute, 8 seconds into the opening period. Well, they're saying it's just the 2 minute variety. So a 2 minute power play. Cunningham Lukes going back to pick it up for Etobicoke. Jackson Cunningham Lukes. He'll dump it in. Hustling over the far side. Jackson gets to it first for New Tech. Sends it the length of the floor. Murphy out to play it. This is Mainville. For Etobicoke, carries it up, shoots it in. Cunningham Lukes able to just hold it in out at center and turned it over as he brought it in over the blue line. A little one-on-one, hustling to get in there. Jackson busted through, and that's going to draw a penalty against Etobicoke. The officials are going to get together, have a quick chat, see if they had the same call. Holding. So that negates the power play for Etobicoke. They'll go 4-on-4. 50. Well, they're taking it off the board, but I think it was 53 seconds left in the Whalers penalty. Get that put back up on the clock for us. Just pausing here, having a look up at the scoreboard, which is down at the end of the arena to our right. And they've been having a little bit of trouble with the penalty time clock over the first few days. Had some delays. Right now, no time showing on either penalty clock. Now they get the 2 minutes up for the Whalers, still waiting for the time to come back up for the New Tech penalty. I believe it was 53 seconds. Well, that is the reason for the delay, folks. Everybody anxiously looking up at the score clock. Yep, 2:03. That's It initially went up as a 2 minute penalty, which I thought was strange. I thought it was supposed to be four for high sticking. All right, so we've got just under 2 minutes left to go in the penalty to New Tech. And just under 2 minutes to go in the penalty to Etobicoke. I paused. I almost said to Hartford with the Whalers out there. Only 3 seconds difference in the two penalties. So barring more penalties or a goal, we'll go 4-on-4 for the next minute, 34 seconds. And Etobicoke are still questioning that penalty time. Get another delay, folks, as one of the officials is coming over to the time clock. And they are going to change it once again, I believe. Okay. So it was. Okay, I'm as confused as everybody. Looks like it was, let's see, only four players out there for New Tech. And for the Whalers, only one penalty showing on the clock. All right, we'll move on. 4-on-4, let them worry about that. The on-floor officials and the off-floor officials. McAuliffe with the good rush. For the Whalers, McAuliffe got to it in the corner and made a nice little back pass. Nobody picked that up. The shot went wide. Here's McAuliffe. His shot over the top of the net. Goes over to the far boards. On it first is Hill. He's pushed against the boards. Trying to work it free. They do. Etobicoke with it. Put it in wide. Came out through the crease the other way, all the way back towards the point. Etobicoke wanted a penalty there. That shot stopped by Vianu, and there is a penalty. Holding. The goaltender raced to the bench. Chance right in front here for Etobicoke. Tristan Hill. Ryan Vigneault with the save. Big slap shot stopped by the defenseman Burke. Changed the time for the New Tech penalty, reset it to 2. So now the Etobicoke penalty has expired, and we've got a minute 36 left to go in the penalty to New Tech. So a power play. Now that's held by the goaltender, you know. Coachella gets an arrow blue line, splits the defense, then they surround him. Ball goes to the boards. First down at New Tech. Down the floor it goes. Cunningham Lokes. He'll bring it in. Gains the zone, flips it over on the right side. Mainville. Back to Cunningham Lokes. He and Mainville crisscross. Into the middle of the floor, shot. That one off the defense into the corner. A couple of players go in there. Now Etobicoke get two in there. Seconds left to go in the penalty to New Tech. Tobago still on the power play. Neri, his shot, that went wide. And New Tech get it, send it down the floor. Time beginning to run out in this power play. Just 20 seconds left. Cunningham looks. No, to Del Colombo, rather. Back to McAuliffe. Neri. His pass back to McAuliffe was picked off. Penalty's over. 5-on-5 coming out of the penalty box. This is Moore. One off the defenseman stick and high over the top of the net. Long shot, stopped by Murphy. Ball goes up and even over the top of the mesh and into the bleachers in behind the goal to our left. Shot hit some bodies in front, ended up in behind the net, goes to the boards. Etobicoke with a chance to move it out here now. Off the boards, are looking up ahead for Demesh. Getting back first was Pichon. Weak clearing attempt off the boards, kept in by Etobicoke, comes to the side of the goal. Vianu has it, and the whistle goes. Towards the blue line, chip past the defense, and a little interference run there, but I was going to say not enough to get a call, but I'm wrong. The referee does call it. Cole Barber gone to the penalty box. 2 minutes interference. At first, I thought he might let it go because the ball was played so far ahead. There's no opportunity for the Etobicoke player to catch it. Went down. Two other players were going after the ball, but he saw the interference and called it. Face-off, it goes in around behind the goal, go into the far corner, picked up over there by Jackson, and Jackson will clear it. Cunningham Lokes. They gained the zone. Pass back to Cunningham Lokes. He gave it away. Short-handed. Hopcraft. Stopped by Cunningham Lokes. It's not been a good-looking power play so far for Etobicoke. They elect to just shoot it in. Need to get in hard on the forecheck. Hustling in there is Del Colombo. And Etobicoke come up with it. Come back to the point. Cunningham Lokes. Over this side, long shot. In scores. It was deflected in front. Cotton with the shot. Leach with the deflection. Here it is. Just one times it. You see Leach set up in front, gets the stick down. Deflects it past goaltender Vieno. Beautiful deflection. Not much a goaltender could do about that. And of course, as soon as I say it's not a good looking power play, they score. In the Etobicoke end, they break out three across. Here they come. The pass was intended for Savaglio. It went off his foot and over the top of the goal. Murphy will leave it for Neary to Price. Gave it away out at center. Long shot in. Murphy steers that to the corner. On it is Oliver. Long pass looking for Savaglio. Heads up, coming up our way. Still didn't get one in the booth. One of these days, I'm going to get one up in the booth. All the years I've been doing this, ice hockey, ball hockey, basketball, volleyball, baseball, never had a ball come up in the booth where I could show off my catching skills and my ducking skills. Suage got it out. Taken by McAuliffe. McAuliffe gains the zone. Had it taken away. Back comes Newtek. Peters. Goes up in the air. Rattles around. And loose ball taken by Etobicoke. Broken up as they get in around the hash marks. Green. Gets it down low. Back at the point. Lots of room. Winding up, ripping it in. Was Castro and kicked away by Murphy. Here to the near side. Acicella got a stick on it. Whistle goes, and I think we're getting too many players on the floor for Etobicoke. They were changing and got too many guys out there. Here's that long shot in, kicked away by Murphy. Castro shooting it. Now this is the one. Castro, given all that time, maybe could have moved in even a few more steps. Newtek now on the power play. Too many players on the floor. That's the call against Etobicoke. Hopcraft, it's a down low to Burke. Burke's shot hit the side of the net, stays there at the side, trying to find it as Murphy actually ended up pulling it out in front to a more dangerous area, but ended up covering it. Let's see, he was reaching for that ball two or three times. Face-off deep in Etobicoke territory, won by New Tech. They'll throw it back to the point to Goble. Looking for Burke. Burke's got it now along the boards. Back to Goble. Up top. That shot comes in and right into the trapper of Murphy. Jackson Davis over on that right side took that shot from top of the circle. Whalers change up their penalty killers. The Whalers get it off the boards, clear it down the floor. Burke, they'll get it in over the blue line. No further than that, though. And a break for New Tecumseh as the clearing attempt by Etobicoke goes into the Etobicoke bench. Let's bring the faceoff back down in the Whalers' end. 50 seconds to go in the power play. Controlled by New Tech, back at the blue line, down into the corner. Goble, Burke, into the slot. Hopcraft, shot, save. Murphy's got a pretty good glove hand, showing that off a few times here in this first period. Whistle went, the officials going over to talk to the New Tech bench. I think they were very slow making their change. Player heading off. So that's being discussed. So the change is a little quicker, guys. Green will come in to take the faceoff. Wins it cleanly. Mitchell. Just holding it, and we'll come over to Carter. Castro down low. Into the slot, another save by Murphy. Good chance for Green as he was set up. Murphy's been solid. Penalty's over. We are 5-on-5 again. New Tech continuing with their possession. That shot goes wide of the goal. Mitchell being pushed back, keeps it onside. That was intercepted by Neary. Now Neary gets away. Neary in over the blue line, staying with it. Tried to feed it in front. That's cleared up and out of play. That last chance for Green. Murphy just drops down. Big goaltender, takes up a lot of space. Yeah. Well, the faceoff will be down to the left of Ryan Bino. Running around the boards. Hustling over there is Kristen. Got to it first, and that will allow Newtek to bring it out. Shot well wide of the goal, maybe hoping for a deflection in front. Tech staying on it. Taken away, and away come the Whalers. Stopped at the blue line. Can't bring that in. That'll be offside. The player on the left was only about 20 feet inside the blue line. And it was touched up by the Newtek players. Kept yelling, offside, offside. And the referee looked at him and said, I got it. I made the call. Relax. Well, thanks for your help, but I got this. Late now in the first period, just the one goal. That by Etobicoke on the deflection in front. Into the final minute now of this first period. Blue line brought in McAuliffe, his shot stopped by Vianu. Try and clear, but stepping up to keep it in, Cunningham Lokes. Just under 40 seconds left. Tried to give it back to Cunningham Lokes as he came off the boards, but passed just a little bit beyond his reach, not by a lot. It's tipped in. Burke doing work along the boards, feeds it down a little bit lower, was looking for McPhail. McPhail has it behind the net. Still 10 seconds to go. McPhail holding it. Back at the point. Kept in. Burke with a chance. Shoots. Another chance. Another save by Murphy. Just got a piece of that first one. And then made the save on the rebound. Ooh, and Murphy's going, I should have caught that first one. So first period comes to an end. Just the one goal. That by Etobicoke Whalers on the power. All right, getting ready for period number two. Shots on goal, by the way, at the end of the first 15 minutes, even at 9 apiece. Players come to center four, and we are about to get underway. Fought and drops it back to his own blue line. Played in by Del Colombo. Mainville trying to work his way in, tied up by the New Tech defense. Ball is still loose. Finally comes three, and away with it is Luke Goble. Hopcraft. Hopcraft trying to come off the boards. Faked a little pass back to the point, thinking he could cut into the middle. Defenseman didn't buy it, stayed with him. Vincent Pacone. Whalers back at the blue line. The shot came in. Save made by Vienno. Hopcraft off the boards. Plays it ahead. Gets it to Davis. Davis still holding it. Comes out in front of the net. And cleared away by Etobicoke. Price came away with it. Price with a shot. Vienno with the save. Oliver here at the left point. Takes it a little further. That shot well wide of the goal. Tracking it down on the other side is Hill. He had it taken away. New Tech couldn't clear the zone though. Kept in by the Whalers. Brazel. Fanned on that pass. That allowed Jackson to get it down the floor. There's a shot and another glove save by Murphy. Chance for Jonah Walmsley. And a quick breakout. If I were New Tech, I'd think about shooting somewhere other than Murphy's glove side. Gets past the two defensemen. Doyle all the way back behind his own goal. Doyle off the boards. That's broken up. Comes three into the middle. A shot quickly fired in wide by McAuliffe. Blue line and over. Player is tripped up. We're going to call slashing. Go against Etobicoke. Slashing, 4 minutes. Davis will come in to take the faceoff for New Tech. Scramble, draw on the circle. New Tech win it. They get it back at the point and set up their power play. Davis, he'll shoot it. Stopped by the forward up high. That was Leach who stopped that. He stopped it with his hand. He's down at the blue line shaking that hand. Gotta get the bee stings out of that one. Aaron pass, flooring. Ryan Vienno. Tristan Hill in to take the faceoff for Etobicoke, wins it cleanly. Mainville shot, may have got a piece of the post as the goaltender, Vienno, kind of whiffed on it. Brought in over the blue line, Davis, having a look around, likes to go back to the point. Burke, back to Davis. Down into the corner. Try and make the pass back to the point. Intercepted. Sent down the floor. Nothing in it yet for Etobicoke on this power play. sorry, for New Tech on the power play. Similar result. It's a 4-minute power play. There's no urgency at all in this New Tech power play, and it's led to complacent play. He'll dump it in, go get it himself. Tyson Jackson pushed against the boards. He'll work himself free, he does. Still holding it. Now he will come back to the point. Goble. And a break there for New Tech, and a tough break for Etobicoke. They're trying to make the pass cross floor. Defenseman slid out to break up the pass. It went off him and in behind Murphy. There's the defenseman sliding out to break up that pass, and tough break for him. There's Tristan Hill, I mean, doing the best he could. Just a tough break. Shot in wide. Moore turning. Can't get it out. Kept in by Etobicoke. Shot by McAuliffe went wide. Came all the way around the boards, and now that will allow New Tech to come out. Backhand, stopped by Murphy. Rossi, had that chance a second ago, had it behind the net, plays it to the half wall, kept in there. Mitchell, back at the point to Moore. Mitchell, still 5-on-4 power play, 4-minute penalty, scoring the first 2 minutes, stay on there. Sulich. Clears it in. Actually, they've got the time still up on the penalty clock, but it is 5-on-5. And this will be a flooring call. Player has to stay in the penalty box for the full 4 minutes, even if they get scored on, but the team does not remain shorthanded, just to clear that up. This penalty clock situation's been causing me fits this morning. That's my excuse. All right, Etobicoke. Getting it out quickly. Seraglio stopped by Vianu. Back at the point. Leach steps into one. Vianu stops that. Stinson with a shot. Stinson's got it again. That doesn't get through. Back at the point. Fired in, stopped by Murphy, kicked away. That was Cole Barber with the shot from the left point. And behind the net. Out of the corner. Leach. Seveglio off the boards, gets it ahead to Mainville. back at the point. Held there by Neary. Neary trying to get free. Neary slips, goes down along the boards. It's going to be a penalty coming up to Etobicoke as they touch it up. Holding the stick. Neary had slipped along the boards just inside the New Tech blue line. And what the referee is saying is while he was down on the floor, he grabbed the New Tech player's stick. That's the penalty. So New Tech back on the power play. Got a 1-1 tie. Goble will center it. Having a look around. Let's go into the slot, scores! Pass to Hopcraft, Hopcraft turned, put it top shelf, and New Tech has taken the lead, 2-1. Their second power play goal here in period two. Here's Goble, instead of going left or right, he goes right down the middle. The Hopcraft was able to turn and beats Murphy over the right shoulder. See Hopcraft just getting in position, rips it, top shelf. So 2-1 now for New Tech. Castro backing up, come this side. We go back to Castro. Oops, a little bit in behind Moore. Now Moore's got it. Off the boards, good pass taken smartly there by Green into the middle. Turning, shooting it off the defenseman, goes in behind the net. This is Peters. Try to give it back to Peters, he's got it. Threw it out in front. Etobicoke will just clear it and get it down the floor. And that will be a flooring call. 6:35 to go here in period number two. Etobicoke struck first, but two power play goals here in the second have New Tech out in front, 2-1. Mitchell in to take the faceoff. He will go against Mainville. Mainville won it. Kept in by New Tech. Off the end boards. Brazel. He stopped as he got out over the blue line. Played back in by Rossi. Going in hard on the forecheck. Connor Christen. Around the boards, back to the point. Percone shot wide of the goal. It redirected and went over the top. Sits on the mesh. And at the end of that play, a slashing call has been made. It's going to go against Tyson Jackson of New Tech. So now Etobicoke will have their chance to go on the power play. Face off won by New Tech. They'll send it down the floor. A 4-minute power play now for the Whalers. We'll try and get even in this one. Cunningham Oaks got it in over the blue line, then had his pocket pick cleared away. He This is Jackson, so it's not Jackson in the penalty box. It was 63, not 43. Jackson doing great work, killing the penalty. Penalty went against Connor Christen. Shot on goal, and we're going to get yet another penalty. No trouble keeping up with all of them. That's where Jackson cut towards the goal. The shorthanded opportunity by Jackson brings about a penalty, and now we'll go 4-on-4. So much for the man advantage for the Whalers. Whalers get it and send it down the floor. And it is 4-on-4. Not sure he realized that as he got the ball and just cleared it the length of the floor. Brazel behind his goal, got it to Neary. Comes up along the boards, kept in by Newtek. Long shot, glove save by Murphy. He's got that. Walmsley floated one in from well out. It will be Walmsley in to take the faceoff now. Won by Etobicoke. Brazel. Neary. To Brazel, Akicella, Neary, McAuliffe. Stepped on the ball initially, then played it to the boards, goes and gets it, shoots it in. Burke in there for Newtek. Burke spinning away from the forechecker. Gave it away at center though, brought in Akicella. The Neary save is made by Vianu. Giveaway right at the blue line. Now Neary's got it. Neary tried the backhanded in front. Goes to the boards. Brazel in there looking for it. Akicella backhand. Tried to go short side, go against the grain and put it a little bit wide. Goble off the boards. He'll get it, can't get it out. Neary reaches up, knocks that out of the air. Neary trying to cut to the goal. Akicella, lots of opportunities, but no real clean shots. Burke had it taken away. Brazel, Brazel making a move. Gets it to his forehand, shoots it. Saved by Vianu. Yachnuk did not get it in over the blue line. Then gave it away. Newtek with a chance to move it. Now that's going to be too many players on the floor against Etobicoke again. The player coming on, the pass came to him. The other player was still on the floor. He jumped off the floor and through the gate after the player who was replacing him touched the ball. So an easy call. Penalty came when they were playing 4-on-4, so it'll now be 4-on-3, and the timekeeper's indicating that the player hadn't come over yet to serve the penalty. Now they've got someone in the box. It's going to be Neary. Neary was just out for a long shift, so They're going to give him a little break. He'll serve the too many players on the floor penalty. Mainville. Actually, I just realized there are two Nerys in the game. Adriano, number 19. And number 12, Aurelio's. Number 12, Aurelio's gone to the penalty box. There's the other Nery who had the long shift. All right, Castro, back in his own end. We'll leave it there for Hopcraft. Lutech changing up their power play. And some new players out there. They gained the zone. It's Peters. Go back at the point. Goble. And the other side. Back for Peters. Back to Goble. Doesn't shoot it. Was looking for Peters. That was chipped just wide. Peters now has it behind the goal into the corner. Peters looking around. Had it taken away from him by Oliver. Oliver to the boards. Taken right back again by Green. Then a shot comes in. Murphy with the save. Great pass from Green from behind the net. Get it to Peters. And Murphy with another save. Here's Peters with it now right along the goal line. Peters shot from a very sharp angle. Murphy no trouble with that. Hustling over. Goble kept it onside. Just got to it. It's the ball set on the center red line. Good hustle. Penalty to the Whalers is now over. Shot comes in wide. Another save made by Murphy. It's 5-on-5. Whalers spinning off the boards, cutting into the middle, backhand. Rattles around in front of Viano. Shot. Viano made the save. Penalty coming up to Newtek. The Tobago player was knocked down. Side of the net. Four minutes. Head contact. We're down to just 12 and a half seconds to go in the period. A penalty-filled period. Now we're getting a misconduct. Burke drew the penalty, argued, drew a misconduct, got in the bench, the penalty box rather, slammed a stick against the glass, and the referee is saying, I believe, you are done. Mason Burke gone from this game. All this with 12 and a half seconds to go in the period. 4 minute power play coming up for Etobicoke. All right, now we're set. Win for Etobicoke. They get the shot, goes wide. Still 6 seconds to go. Back at the point, winding up. Cunningham looks. That deflected just wide. All right, the rest of that penalty will carry over into period three. 3 minutes, 48 seconds left to go in that penalty to Newtek. And we will have the third period upcoming. And players are lined up at center for the start of period number three. Just a one-goal game. Intact leading this 2-1. A couple of power play goals in the second period. Etobicoke on the power play. 4-minute penalty assessed with just 12 seconds left to go against Newtek. 4 minutes for head contact. Moore then argued the call and ended up getting ejected. Tobago throwing it around, just listening to the announcement of the penalty that came at the end of the second period. Cunningham Oaks, Del Colombo shot wide, picked up on the far side, and Mainville. Cunningham Lokes, Del Colombo, they go back up top once again. That shot stopped by the defense. Del Colombo, his shot blocked as well. That one blocked by Braden Doyle. And Newtek now, shorthanded, get it down the floor and racing down there. It's Tyson Jackson, goaltender Murphy came out and played it. Jackson causing more trouble. Sends it back down in the Etobicoke end. First half of that 4 minute penalty has been killed. Got 2 minutes left. Mainville will come back and start things off here for the Whalers. Stick handle in. Ends up kicking it down deep to the boards. And he'll go in to forecheck. Two players from each team in there. Tobago needs to get in there and outman them. On the power play. Now a third player comes in trying to hook it loose. That was Brazel. Brazel's pinned to the boards. Finally they get it free. Mainville up top. They come this side. Clotten shot off the heel of his stick. Mainville back at the point. Neary shoots, scores! Somehow found a path to the net from well out. There was a screen in front. And it beats the goaltender, and we are tied at two. This is Neary. Adriano Neary. Nothing complicated about this. You see some traffic in front shooting. You could tell goaltender Viena really didn't see that, didn't move till it was past him. Another question down at the penalty box about the penalties. Go 5-on-5 at the okay, they're going to let the player come out. Castro. Back behind his own goal. All over him is McAuliffe. Dumped into the Etobicoke end. Neary is back to get it. They close on him very quickly, up along the boards. Shot right back in, but did not clear the zone, so it's onside. And they give it away at the blue line. Flipped up ahead. Acicella looking for it. Viena will cover that. And the faceoff will be in the Newtek end. Both teams will change. Shots on goal, 18-17, favoring Newtek. Now actually tied at 18 on the shots on goal. Tied at 2 in goals, seems fair. Just golfed in deep, back to get it. Doyle, he'll reverse it to Barber. Kept in. Green able to get it out. Oliver's got to hustle back. Walmsley on him right away. Oliver gets it to the other side. Cunningham Lokes. Trouble getting it out of their own end. Back and forth they go, east and west. Now they get a little north-south going. This will come down to Vienna, and again he will cover it with Anthony Demesh right there. Out at center, Brazel has it. Drifts it in. That got through to the goal. Viano clears it away. The rebound is there and put wide. McPhail trying to get it out, but it's dumped back in by Etobicoke. Moore. Again, Brazel stops it at center. That long shot. Redirected over the top of the goal. Backhand stopped by Villeneuve. Another chance. Villeneuve stops that one. Vianu, rather. 3 or 4 good chances for Etobicoke on this shift. So, New Tech will change. Gets past the defenseman. Davis has it. Davis couldn't get a shot away. Leach knocked it off his stick. Ball bouncing around. New Tech on it. Goes high in the air, knocked down. First touch by New Tech, so play continues. Del Colombo clears it down the floor. Castro back to get it. Castro stopping behind his goal. Flushed out of there by Clotten. There's Davis. Davis will shoot it. Right on goal. Stick save. Cleared it to the boards. Murphy. Clotten couldn't get it out. Kept in by New Tech. Lifted high in the air over the head of the defenseman. To the boards it goes. Back at the point. Castro trying to get away from Clotten. Forced back to center. Castro will shoot it. That went off a stick and Etobicoke will come the other way. That was Clotten who stopped it. Clotten gets to center, shoots it in, heads to the bench. Quickly up. Thrown to an open wing. Racing onto it. New Tech. Acacella behind his goal. It's McAuliffe. New Tech come up with it. Lug it out. It's Mitchell. Mitchell in over the blue line. Mitchell. He'll drop it off. Rossi back behind the goal. Neary back there first for Etobicoke. Yakna to McAuliffe. McAuliffe holding it, waiting for his teammates to come on. He's pushed off the ball. And that will allow New Tech to bring it in. back to the point. Long shot high over the top of the goal. Mitchell's on it. Mitchell trying to spin away. Stick got engaged. Mitchell lost his stick, and Etobicoke will pick up a penalty. Ooh, yeah, that stick got up high. So, high sticking. Power play for New Tech. We're down to 7:13 to go here in the third period. Adriano Neri scored the last goal for the Whalers to tie this one up. Has now gone to the penalty box. As the referee comes over to talk to the penalty timekeeper, Etobicoke has called a timeout. They initially put 2 minutes up on the clock as the penalty. They've got that fixed. It is 4 minutes for high sticking. So we take a look at some recent play. All right, timeout is over. 7:13 to go here in the third period. We've got a 2-2 tie, and New Tech about to try and take advantage of a 4-minute power play. Hopcraft in to take the faceoff against Hill. New Tech with the ball just outside the blue line. Castro throws it back up top. It's Goble. Hopcraft. We'll go the other side. Back to Hopcraft, off his foot, then off a stick. Ball goes high in the air. Controlled over there by Davis. Back to Hopcraft. We'll leave it there for Goble. Back to Davis. Didn't get much on that. Davis has to go over and get it. Down into the corner. Back, Davis can't shoot it. They go to the other side, winding up and ripping it wide. It was Castro. Davis, Goble. Back to Davis. Again down in the corner, they have a look around. Back pass to Davis. Goble. Davis, shot wide. Castro's got it off the boards. Castro, down the corner, back the point. Bad pass, he was looking for Goble. And that'll send New Tech back into their own end. They get it in, Jackson. Jackson, back at the point, that's intercepted. Comes out over the red line, now even a little further. Hopcraft, a little trouble with it. Back comes New Tech. Jackson, trying to split the defense. Couldn't beat Brazel, stayed with him. Castro's got it behind the goal. Castro. Davis holds the line, back to Hopcraft. Long shot in, stopped by Murphy, and he'll cover the rebound. 1:46 to go in the 4-minute penalty. So far, a pretty good job by the Etobicoke Whalers to kill this one off. Mitchell, a new power play unit out there now for New Tech, Percone. They work the other side, shot way off the mark. That went high and wide. Vincent Picone. It's onside. They bring it in. Green tried to feed it in front. Went off a stick of Brazel. Green's got it again. Mitchell, he'll shoot it. Comes back to Mitchell. He'll shoot it again. Again, it stopped. Too many bodies in front of the goal. None of those got through. Long stretch pass. Mitchell fed it out in front. It's cleared him behind the goal again. Down to 35 seconds to go in the power play. Mitchell all over the place, but can't get the shots through. Green. Green back up top. Mitchell. That rang off the goalpost. Had trouble getting him through to the net. Finally does and hits iron. And then it's covered by Murphy. Landon Mitchell doing everything he could to get his team out in front. So down to just 3:27 left to go. 14 seconds left to go in the power play. And the Whalers will clear it, and that will pretty much do it for the power play. In 5 seconds, the Etobicoke player will be back out on the floor. And Neary comes out of the penalty box now. Hutek still in control of the ball. Castro had a little bit of trouble with it, finally gets it under control. Goble into the high slot. Jackson had it knocked off his stick. Goble keeps it in play. Shot from a sharp angle. Once again, the glove of Murphy puts a stop to the play. Easy pickings there for Michael Murphy. Into the slot. Pass across. Oh my goodness! How did that not go in? Did Murphy get a stick on that? That looked like a completely empty net. Nothing there but air. And it didn't go in. We're going to have another look in a minute, I hope. If Murphy got a stick in that, and I think he did, that's the best save I have seen in a long, long time. Hutek staying with it. Castro shoots. Murphy's got that. That's a little easier save. Takes that right in the chest. Look at this. Wide open net. Murphy doesn't even know where the... And he does! He gets the paddle over. Did he stop it? Did it go wide? Two of us are looking at it. We're not sure still, even on the replay. One more time. I think he got the paddle of the stick on it. Hutek coming that close. Shot by Hill went wide. He's got it now in the corner. Gives it to Mainville. Mainville trying to spin off the boards. That's a glove pass. They missed it. Whoa, and you can hear the Whalers bench. Player down was down on the floor, lying on his back, and he clearly just gloved it to his teammate. Assume the referee didn't, may have been blocked out, didn't have the same clear angle that we did from up here. All right, Hutek back on the offense. Cleared away by Murphy as the ball bounced through the crease. into the final minute. This tie game. Player tripped up. Add to some drama in this one. We're going to get a power play for Etobicoke in the final minute, 52.4 seconds left. Here we go. Face off in the New Tech end. Goes to the boards. New Tech would love to keep it there for a little bit longer. Etobicoke work it free. They've got it now. They can set up their power play. Cunningham Lokes. That shot, stopped by Viena, the rebound is there. Shot blocked, Cunningham Lokes has it again. McAuliffe, Cunningham Lokes, he'll go the other side. Hill, Cunningham Lokes, shot, save made, rebound is there. Defense stops it, it's put through the crease, rattles around and finally cleared away and out of play. 7.1 seconds left. So close. Have a look. There's the first save. And the rebound is cleared by the defense, and then it's backhanded towards the goal. Viena falling back in the net. They keep it out. It's the first save. And the defenseman clearing it. Back into the crease. It went off and Etobicoke sticks, so the faceoff comes outside the blue line. And penalty's called, but it's not going to matter. It won't be touched up until after the horn goes. That's an accounting penalty there. Well, hang on a minute. My understanding was no overtime in the round robin games, preliminary games. That's clearly not going to be the case. Actually, I think the referee just indicated what I had said. They'd sent the players to the penalty box, but then the referee came over and kind of waved it off. The safe signal you get in baseball, kind of meaning it's over. We're done, I think. I don't remember a game that I found so confusing as this one. Second period had all kinds of trouble. At the other guys here in the broadcast area with me, and everybody's going, what's going on? Yeah, this game's over. I got one right, folks. No overtime in the preliminaries. This game will end in a 2-2 tie. All right, now we know. It's pretty sure ahead of time, but when they started sending players to the penalty box, I began to question myself. Should never do that. All right. There's two U-17 games done in the boys' division. We're going to switch now to the U-15. We're going to have a couple of games in that, starting with Team Alberta versus New Tech Extreme, followed by the New Brunswick Mooseheads. First look at New Brunswick here at Pad 1 in Merlis Belcher, and they will take on the Withrow Park Knights. So that's our next two games, and then we're going to go to the girls for a couple of games, and then back to the boys before we finish up about 10 o'clock or 10:30 tonight. All right, let's take a break. We'll be back in a couple of minutes. We'll switch things over to the boys U-15. These are the 2024 Canadian National Junior Ball Hockey Championships from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan.